Good afternoon, my dear students, colleagues and friends. This is video number 132 in a series of lectures on introduction to statistics, and today this is lecture number 2, which is based on descriptive statistics. Let me start with the some basics. As I mentioned yesterday, statistics is the science of collection, presentation, analysis and reasonable presentation of data. It presents a rigorous scientific method for gaining insight into data. For example, suppose we measure the weight of 100 patients in a study. With so many measurements, simply looking at the raw data fails to provide an informative account. However, statistics can give an instant overall picture of the data based on graphical presentation or numerical summarization, irrespective to the number of data points. Besides data summarization, another important task of statistics is to make inference and predict relations of variables. This is a taxonomy of statistics. There are two types of statistical methods, descriptive methods and inferential methods. Under descriptive methods, we have univariate, bivariate and multivariate relationship. In univariate relationship, we have a shape of the distribution of data on single variable, the central tendency, the spread or dispersion, or the relative position. Under bivariate relations, we have correlation between two variables or regressions of one dependent variable or another independent variable. This is a simple linear regression. And in multivariate regression, we have multiple regression models. Under inferential methods, we apply these methods to two groups, and then we may have a pair t-test or independent sample t-test, and we may also have ANOVA, and this can also be applied to other statistics. Statistical description of data. Statistics describes a numeric set of data by its measure of central tendency, measure of dispersion or variability, and shape of the data. Statistics describes categorical set of data by frequency distribution, percentages or proportion of each category. Here are some definitions. Let me start with the variable. A variable is any characteristic of an individual or entity. It can take different values for different individuals, and variables can be categorical or quantitative. Following are the scales of measurement, and these include nominal, ordinal, interval or ratio. Categorical variables with no inherent order or ranking sequence, such as names or classes, for example gender, value may be a numerical but without numerical value, for example 1, 2, 3. The only operation that can be applied to nominal variable is enumeration, that is just we can count them. Ordinal variables with an inherent rank or order, for example mild, moderate, severe, can be compared for equality or greater or less, but not how much greater or less. Then we have interval scales, and here values of variable are ordered as in ordinal, and additionally differences between values are meaningful. However, the scale is not absolutely anchored. Calendar dates and temperatures and the Fahrenheit scale and centigrade scales are examples. Addition and subtraction, but not multiplication and divisions, are meaningful operations under interval scales. Finally, we have ratio scales, and here variables with all properties of interval plus an absolute non-arbitrary zero point, for example age, weight, temperature based on Kelvin measurement, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, all are meaningful operation. So it means the only difference between interval scale of measurement and ratio scale of measurement is that meaningful zero exist under ratio scale, but there is no absolute zero in interval scale. For example, zero centigrade or zero Fahrenheit does not mean that the temperature is zero, there is no temperature, because in under centigrade and Fahrenheit scale, zero temperature means a particular level of temperature. So the only difference between these two scales is that under ratio we have absolute zero, but under interval scale we don't have absolute zero. And then we have distributions. Distribution of a variable tells us what values the variable takes and how often it takes these values. The distribution may be unimodal, having a single peak, bimodal, having two distinct peaks, and may be symmetric. Left and right half are mirror images. Frequency distribution. Let us suppose we have a data set of 26 children of ages from 1 to 6 years. Then the frequency distribution of variable age can be tabulated as follows. Frequency distribution of age. In the first row, we measure age from 1 to 6 years. In the second row, we measure frequency of the age. So this means there are 5 children of age 1. There are 3 children of age 2 years, and so on. But we can also convert this data into grouped. And here we see this is the grouped frequency distribution of age. 1 to 2 is 8. And this is 1 to 2, so we sum up these two values. So this turns out to be 8. Similarly, from 3 to 4, it is 12. And the frequency from 5 to 6 is 6. So this is a frequency distribution of a grouped data. This is a cumulative frequency distribution. Here we also have individual frequencies as well as the cumulative frequencies. So if this is 5, then we sum up this with this one, that gives us 8, and then if we add this with this, we get 15, and so on. And finally, the cumulative frequency is 16. And here this is for the grouped data. This is individual frequency, and these are the cumulative frequencies. Data presentation. Two types of statistical presentation of data are there. One is graphical and the other one is numerical. Graphical presentation. We look for the overall pattern and for striking deviations from that pattern. Overall pattern usually described by the shape, center and spread of the data. An individual value that falls outside the overall pattern is called an outlier. Bar diagram and pie charts are used for categorical variables, whereas histograms, stem and leaf and box plots are used for numerical or quantitative data. This is a data presentation for categorical variable, and this is bar diagram. Now this lists the categories and presents the percent or count of individuals who fall in each category. Now in this table we have three treatment groups, 1, 2 and 3, and these are the frequencies of these groups. Here is the total, these are the proportion. So this proportion is 15 out of 60, so the proportion is 0.25, and here this is 25 out of 60, this becomes 0.33, and this proportion is 0.417. and if we sum up these proportions, that then the sum is equal to 1, and here these are the percentages. So if you multiply this by 100, you get 25, and I think this value should be here. That should be 41.7%, and this value should be here. So let me correct this. This should be 33.3, and this should be 41.7. So this is almost 42. So this is data presentation of the categorical variable. This is data presentation also of the categorical variable, and here we have this is the pie chart of the subjects in treatment group, and these are the percentages. This 25% comes from here, this 33% comes from here, and this 42% comes from here. So let me also correct this. This should be 33.3, and this should be 41.7. So this is almost 42%. Let me save this. And this is graphical presentation, and there are some numerical values, and this is not box diagram, this is histogram, and it shows the overall pattern, which can be described by its shape, center, and spread. The following age distribution is right skewed. The center lies between 80 to 100, and no outliers. There are no outliers. So here is the mean value, and this is the standard deviation. This is the median, and this is the mode. This is the standard deviation. This is sample variance. This is kurtosis. This is Q-ness, that is the range. Range is the difference between the maximum and the minimum value. And here are minimum and maximum values. And this is the sum, that is the total, and this is the count. And this is also graphical presentation of numerical variable, that is age. And this type of diagram is known as box plot. And it describes five number summary. It tells us about the median. The median is given by this yellow, and this is the minimum, this is the maximum, and this is the quartile 3, and this is quartile 1. So we have five number summary in this box plot. Numerical presentation. A fundamental concept in summary statistics is that of a central value for a set of observations, and the extent to which the central value characterizes the whole set of data. Measures of central value, such as the mean or median, must be coupled with measure of data dispersion, that is average distance from the mean, to indicate how well the central value characterizes the set as a whole. To understand how well a central value characterizes a set of observations, let us consider the following two sets of data. This is set A, in which there are three numbers, 30, 50, and 70. In the data set B, there are also three numbers, but one is 40, one is 50, and one is 60. The mean of both the data set is 50. If you take the mean, that will be equal to 50 here, and if we calculate the mean for this data set, it will also be equal to 50, but the distance of the observations from the mean in data set A is larger as compared to the distance of the observations from the mean in the data set B. So therefore, the mean of the data set B is a better representation of the data set than is the case of for set A. A method of central tendency. A central measurement is a summary measure of the overall level of a data set. commonly used methods are mean, median, mode, geometric mean, and harmonic mean. Mean, we start with mean. Mean is calculated by summing up all the observations and dividing by number of observations. So, mean of 20, 30, and 40 is given by to sum up 20, 30, and 40 and divided by 3, and that will be equal to 30. So, 30 is the mean of this data set. Let me use some notation. Let x1, x2, and up to xn are the n observations of a variable x, then the mean of this variable can be calculated by x bar, where x bar is equal to x1, x2, up to xn divided by n, and that is equal to summation I varies from 1 to n xi divided by n. So that is the mean of this variable. Median. The middle value of an order sequence of observations is called median. That is, to find the median, we need to order the data set in ascending or descending order and then find the middle value. In case of an even number of observations, the average of the two middlemost values is the median. For example, to find the median of these five values, 9, 3, 6, 7, 5, we first sort the data, giving 3, 5, 6, 7, 9, then choose the middle value 6 as median. If the number of observations is even, say for example 9, 3, 6, 7, 5, 2, then the median is the average of the two middle values from the sorted sequence, and in this case that will be 5 plus 6 divided by 2, so 5.5 is the median now. The third measurement of the central tendency is mode. The value that is observed most frequently is called mode. The mode is undefined for sequences in which no observations is repeated. Mean or median, which one is more representative? The median is less sensitive to the outliers, and by outliers we mean extreme scores, than the mean, and therefore a better measure than the mean for highly skewed distributions. Say for example family income. Let us suppose mean of 20, 30, 40 and 990 is equal to 270. However, the median of these four observations is equal to 30 plus 40 divided by 2, and that is equal to 35. So here three observations out of four lie between 20 to 40. So the mean of 270 really fails to give a realistic picture of the major part of the data. It is influenced by the extreme value that is 990. So in that case, a mean is not a reliable representation or a good representation or a good measure of the central tendency, whereas the median is. Methods of variability measurement are methods of dispersion. Variability or dispersion measures the amount of scatter in a data set. The most commonly used methods are range, variance, standard deviation, interquartile range, semi-interquartile range, and coefficient of variation, etc. Let me define range. Range is the difference between the maximum and the minimum observations. The range of 10, 5, 2 and 100 is equal to the difference between the maximum, that is 100, and the minimum, that is 2, so that is equal to 98. It is a crude measure of dispersion. Variance. The variance of a set of observations is the average of the squares of the deviations of the observations from their mean. Symbolically, the variance of the n observations from x1 to xn is given by s square, which is equal to x1 minus x bar square plus x2 minus x bar square up to xn minus x bar square whole divided by n minus 1. So variance of 573 is how this can be calculated. So first we will calculate mean. So the mean of these three is 5 plus 7 12 plus 315, and divide by 3, that is equal to 5, and the variance is calculated by this 5 minus 5 square, 3 minus 5 square, 7 minus 5 square, and n minus 1 divided by n minus 1, so that is equal to 4. So 4 is the variance of this data set. Standard deviation is the square root of the variance. The standard deviation of the above example is 2, because if we take the square root of 4, that will be equal to 2. Quartiles. Data can be divided into 4 regions that cover the total range of observed values. Cut points for these regions are known as quartiles. In notation terms, quartiles of a data is the n plus 1 divided by 4 qth quartileth observation of the data, where q is the desired quartile and n is the number of observations of data. The first quartile is q1 and it is the first 25% of the data. The second quartile q2 is between 25th and 50th percentage points in the data. The upper bound q2 is the median. The third quartile q3 is the 25% of the data lying between the median and the 75% cut point in that data. Q1 is the median of the first half of the ordered observation, and Q3 is the median of the second half of the ordered observations. In the following example, Q1 is equal to 15 plus 1 divided by 4 into 1 is equal to 4th observations of the data. The 4th observation in the data is 11. So Q1 of this data is 11. Example with 15 numbers. Now what will be Q1, Q2 and Q3? So the first quartile is Q1 is equal to 11. The second quartile is Q2 is equal to 40 here, and this is also the median, and the third quartile is 61. Interquartile range, difference between Q3 and Q1. So interquartile range of the previous example is 61 minus 40, which is equal to 21. The middle half of the ordered lie between 40 and 61. Deciles and percentiles. If data is ordered and divided into 10 parts, then the cut points are called deciles. If data is ordered and divided into 100 parts, then the cut points are called percentiles. 25th percentile is the Q1, 50th percentile is the median, and 75th percentile is of the data is Q3, that is third quartile. In notation, percentiles of the data is n plus 1 divided by 100 pth observation of the data, where p is the desired percentile and n is the number of observations of the data. Finally, we may also use coefficient of variation as measure of dispersion. The standard deviation of the data divided by its mean, it is usually expressed in percent term, and that gives us coefficient of variation. So it means that if we divide the standard deviation of the data by mean of that data set and multiply by 100, what we get is known as coefficient of variation. 5-number summary. The 5-number summary of a distribution consists of the minimum observation, or the smallest number, the first quartile, the median or second quartile, the third quartile, the largest or the maximum observation, written in order from smallest to largest. Box plot. A box plot is a graph of 5-number summary. The central box spans the quartiles. A line between the box marks the median. Lines extending above and below the box mark the smallest and the largest observations, that is the range. Outlying samples may be additionally plotted outside the range. And this is an example of the box plot. Here you see the distribution of age in month, and these are the 5-number summary. You see there are 5 numbers. 1, this is the minimum. this is the first quartile, this is the median, this is the third quartile, and this is the maximum value. So that is why box plot is also known as a five number summary. Choosing a summary. The five number summary is usually better than the mean and standard deviation for describing a skewed distribution or a distribution with the extreme outliers. The mean and standard deviations are reasonable for symmetric distribution that are free of outliers. In real life, we can't always expect symmetry of the data. So it is a common practice to include number of observations, mean, median, standard deviation, and range as common for data summarization purpose. We can include other summary statistics like first quartile, third quartile, coefficient of variation if it is considered to be important for describing data. Shape of data. Shape of data is measured by two measures. One is skewness and one is kurtosis. So let me start with the skewness first. Skewness measures asymmetry of data. We may have a positive skewness or negative skewness. Positive or right skewed have longer right tail. Negative or left skewed distribution have longer left tail. Let x1, x2 up to xn be n observations, then skewness can be computed by the formula, which is equal to n under root summation I varies from 1 to n into xi minus x bar cube whole divided by summation xi minus x bar square whole raised to the power 3 by 2. So this is the formula for skewness. And here is kurtosis. Kurtosis measures peakedness of the distribution of data. The kurtosis of normal distribution is 0. Let x1, x2 up to xn be n observations, then the kurtosis can be computed by this formula, which is given by n times summation I varies from 1 to n xi minus x bar raised to the power 4 whole divided by summation I varies from 1 to n xi minus x bar raised to the power 2 whole raised to the power 2 minus 3. And this is the summary of the variable age in the given data set. On the right hand side, you see the histogram of age. This is age in month, and vertically we measure a number of subjects. And on the left hand side, we see the summary of the variable with the help of various measures. We have mean, we have standard deviation, we have standard error, we have median, we have mode, we have standard deviation, we have sample variance, we have kurtosis, we have skewness, range, minimum, maximum, sum, and count, number of counts. This is also summary of the variable age in the given data set by box plot of age in month. And there are five number summary. This is the minimum, this is the maximum, this is the median, this is first quartile, and this is the third quartile. Class summary. So far, we have learned statistics and data presentation or data summarization, a graphical presentation, bar chart, pie chart, histogram, and box plot. We discussed all these, and then we also discussed numerical presentation, and we discussed measuring central measure of central tendency, that is measuring central value of data, and that included mean, median, mode, etc. And then we also discussed measure of dispersion, and there is the common measures of dispersion include standard deviation, variance, coefficient of variation, range, interquartile range, semi-interquartile range, quartiles, percentiles, and five number summary. A brief concept of statistical softwares. There are a large number of statistical softwares that researchers use for data analysis. So there are many softwares to perform statistical analysis and visualization of data. Some of them are SAS. SAS stands for System of Statistical Analysis, S+, R, MATLAB, Minitab, BMDP, Stata, SPSS, Stata Exact, Statistica, LISREL, JMP, GLIM, HIL, MS Excel, Gretel, and so on. Here we will briefly discuss MS Excel and SPSS. Some useful websites for more information of statistical softwares are here. You may check out these and you may find many important and interesting softwares that you may use for your data analysis. So we start with the Microsoft Excel. It is a spreadsheet application. It features calculation, graphing tools, pivot tables, and a macro programming language called Visual Basics for applications. And there are many versions of MS Excel: Excel XP, Excel 2003, Excel 2017 are capable of programming a number of statistical analyses. And starting MS Excel, double click on the Microsoft Excel icon on the desktop, or click on the Start Programs and Microsoft Excel, and then you will get worksheet which will consist of a multiple grid of cells with numbered rows down the page and alphabetically titled columns across the page. Each cell is referenced by its coordinates. For example, A3 is used to refer to the cell in A, in column A, and row 3, and B10 to B20 is used to refer to the range of cells in column B and rows 10 through 20. Opening of a document, click on File and then open from an existing workbook, or change the directory or drive to look for a file in other locations. Creating a new workbook, File, New, Blank Document. Saving a file, File, Save. Selecting more than one cell, click on the cell, say for example A1, then hold the Shift key and click on another number, say D3, to select cells between A1 and D4, or click on a cell and drag the mouse across the desired range. Creating formulas. Number 1, click the cell that you want to enter the formula. 2, type equal sign. 3, click the function button. 4, select the formula you want to and step through the on-screen instructions with the function fx. Entering the data and time. Dates are stored as a month, day, year. No need to enter in that format. For example, Excel will recognize January 9 and Jan 9 as 1-9-2007 and January 9, 1999 as 1-9-1999. To enter today's date, press Control and this sign together. Use a RP to indicate AM or PM. For example, 8:30 p is inserted as 8:30 p.m. To enter current time, press Control and Column together. Copy and paste all cells in sheet. Control A for selecting, Control C for copying, and Control V for pasting. Storing data. Sorting data, and you go to data and then to sort, and then sort by ascending or descending order. And then there are descriptive statistics and other statistical methods, tools, data analysis, statistical method. If data analysis is not available, then click on tool, add ins, and then select analysis tool pick and analysis tool pick VBA. And then you can also use regression analysis. Statistical and mathematical functions. Start with the equal sign and then select function from function wizard, that is fx. Inserting a chart, click on chart wizard, insert chart, select chart, give input range, update and chart options, and select output range and worksheet. Similarly, you can also import data in Excel. File, open file, type, click on file, choose option, delimited, fixed width, choose option, tab, semicolon, comma, space, other, and finish. And there are some limitations of Excel. Excel uses algorithms that are vulnerable to rounding and truncation errors and may produce inaccurate results in extreme cases. Let me also briefly discuss the use of SPSS. SPSS stands for Statistical Package for Social Sciences. A general purpose of a statistical package is widely used in the social sciences, particularly in sociology, psychology, and also in economics and management sciences, SPSS can import data from almost any type of file to generate tabulated reports, plots of distributions and trends, descriptive statistics, and complex statistical analysis. Starting SPSS, you may double click on SPSS on desktop, or you may go to SPSS in the program. So opening SPSS file, go to file and then go open, and then there are menus and toolbars, and you have data editor. Various pull down menus appear at the top of the data editor window. These pull down menus are at the heart of the using SPSS win. The data editor menu items with some of the uses of the menu include, that is, menus and the toolbars, file, which is used to open and save data files. Then there is edit, and this is used to copy and paste data values, used to find data in a file, insert variables and cases. Options allows the user to set general preferences as well as the setup for the navigator, charts, etc. View, user can change toolbars, value labels can be seen in cells instead of data values, and data, select, sort, weight cases, merge files, transform, compute new variable, record variables, etc. Analyze, perform various statistical analysis and procedures, graphs, create bar and pie charts, etc. Utilities, add comments to accompany data file and our advanced features, add-ons, these are features not currently installed, advanced statistical procedure, a window, switch between data, syntax and navigator windows, help to access SPSS win help information. Navigator output menus, when statistical procedures are run or charts are created, the output will appear in the navigator window. The navigator window contains many of the pull down menus found in the data editor window. Some of the important menus in the navigator windows include insert, which is used to insert page breaks, titles, charts, etc. Format, which is used for changing the alignment of a particular portion of the output. Formatting toolbars, when a table has been created by a statistical method, the user can edit the table to create a desired look or add or delete information. Beginning with version 14, the user has a choice of editing the table in the output or opening it in a separate view table window. Various pull down menus are activated when the user double click on the table, and these include edit, insert, pivot, format. Additional menus are chart editor, used to edit graph, syntax editor, used to edit the text in the syntax window, show or hide toolbar, click on view toolbar to show it or to hide it, move a toolbar, click on the toolbar but not on one of the push buttons and then drag the toolbar to its new location, customize toolbar, click on view toolbars and customize, and you can also import data from Excel spreadsheet into SPSS, and data from an Excel spreadsheet can be imported into SPSS win as follows. In SPSS win, click on file, open data. The open data file dialog box will disappear. Locate the file of interest. Use the look in pull down list to identify the folder containing the Excel file of interest. From the file type pull down menu, select Excel. Click on the file name of interest and click on open, or simply double click on the file name. Keep the box checked that read variable names as the first row of the data. This assumes that the first row of the Excel data file contains variable names in the first row. If the data resided in a different worksheet in the Excel file, this would need to be entered. Click on OK. The Excel data file will now appear in the SPSS win data editor. The former Excel spreadsheet can now be saved as an SPSS file. File, save as, and is ready to be used in analysis. Typically, you would label variable and values and define missing values. Importing an access table a species win does not offer a direct import of access table. Therefore, we must follow three steps. Open the access file, open the data table, save the data table as an Excel file. Follow the steps outlined in the data import from Excel spreadsheet to SPSS Win. Importing text files into SPSS Win, text data points typically are separated or delimited by tabs or commas. Sometimes they can be of fixed format. In SPSS Win, click on File, then Open, then Data. Look in the appropriate location for the text file, then select text from files of type. Click on the file name and then click on open. You will see the text import wizard step 1 to 6 dialog box. You will now have an SPSS data file containing the former tab delimited data. You simply need to add variable and value labels and define missing values. Exporting data to Excel. Click on file, save as. Click the file name for the file to be exported. For the save as type, select the pull down menu Excel. You will notice the checkbox for write variable names to spreadsheet. Leave this checked as you will want the variable names to be in the first row of each column in the Excel spreadsheet. Finally, click on save. Running frequencies procedure, open the data file. From menu, click on file, open data of interest. From the menus, click on Analyze, Descriptive Statistic, and Frequencies. The Frequencies dialog box will appear. In the left-hand box will be a listing source variable of all variables that have been defined in the data file. The first step is identifying the variables for which you want to run a frequency analysis. Click on a variable names, then click the push button. The variable names will now appear in the variables box. Selected variables. Repeat these steps for each variable of interest. If all that is being requested is a frequency table showing count, percentages, raw, adjusted, and cumulative, then click on OK. Descriptive and summary statistics can be requested for numeric variables. To request statistics from the frequencies dialog box, click on the statistics push button that will bring up frequencies statistic dialog box. The statistics dialog box offers the user a variety of choices. Descriptives. The descriptive procedure can be used to generate descriptive statistics. Click on Analyze, then Descriptive Statistics, then Descriptives. The procedure offers many of the same statistics as the frequency procedure, but without generating frequency analysis tables. Requesting charts. One can also request graphs are charts to be created for a variable or variables included in a frequency procedure. In the frequencies dialog box, click on charts. The frequencies charts dialog box will appear. Choose the intended chart, that is bar diagram, pie chart, or histogram. Pasting charts into Word, click on the chart. Click on the pull down menu, edit, copy, objects, and go to the Word document in which the chart is to be embedded. Click on edit, paste special, select formatted text, RTF, and then click on OK. Enlarge the graph to a desired size by dragging one or more of the black squares along the perimeter. If the blank squares are not visible, click once on the graph. Basic statistical procedure like cross tabs. From the analysis pull down menu, click on descriptive statistics and then cross tabs. The cross tab dialog box will then open. From the variable selection box on the left, click on a variable you wish to designate as the row variable. The values codes for the row variable make up the rows of the cross tabs. Click on the arrow button for rows. Next, click on a different variable you wish to designate as the column variable. The values codes for the column variable make up the columns of the cross tabs, and then click on the arrow button for columns. You can specify more than one variable in the row and or columns. A cross table will be generated for each combination of row and column variables. Limitations. There are certain limitations of SPSS. SPSS users have less control over the data manipulation and statistical output than other statistical packages like SAS and Stata. SPSS is a good first statistical package to perform quantitative research in social science, because it is easy to use and because it can be a good starting point to learn more advanced statistical packages. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you very much for watching this video. If you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, kindly do subscribe to the channel, and do not forget to click on bell icon so that you can get notification about my other videos. Thank you, and have a very good afternoon on Sunday. Enjoy your Sunday also. Thank you.